I'm Matt from Winnetka Bowling League, and I play guitar, and I sing. It's been good. I feel like it, after the first two or three shows, it felt a lot less weird than you expected it to. It was really strange to get back on stage and play after not having played for 2 years, because you're so used to sort of being in a rhythm when you're on tour, that to not have that leaping point, or, you know, to not be able to say, oh, we were touring 4 months ago, and be in a rhythm, it's really strange. But I'd say about a week and a half into it, it feels completely normal, and it's been rad to see audiences, you know, coming and masking up and just doing kind of their part to make it possible for us to keep being able to tour. So it's felt really good. Yeah, for sure. I feel like, you know, it depends where you are. It's different from city to city, for sure. For the most part, we're playing cities, so it's pretty progressive wherever we're playing, but there's definitely an enthusiasm for we haven't seen live music. Some people are coming to our show and they haven't seen a show since our last show, which was right up till when lockdown was. So there's definitely an excitement that I don't know that I've felt before from people, because there's some starvation of, like, we haven't been doing this for 2 years, so. My brother, who sort of puts together all of our touring stuff, he's the guy behind all of the gear we use. I sort of am more the studio guy, so when it comes to touring, Chris is the one who steps up and figures out what we gotta be doing, and he came to me and was like, I love this mic, it's a 945, you should try it in rehearsal, see if you like it. And it just was really crisp, and I tend to like my ear mix, at least, really kind of bright and crunchy. And this sort of did that naturally for me without having to do too much processing or anything. So it made the most sense for me. And then when our front of house heard it, he loved it. So it was a happy marriage of cool. We're gonna stick to this because I like it. And you're so selfish as a musician, you just want to hear yourself sounding good, that everything else sort of comes secondary to that. So you're like, great, front of house is good with it too. We're good.
I'm Sam, and I play keyboard and sing background vocals. Pulp kind of came about during quarantine when Matt and I were in New York last winter, kind of in the snow and just literally indoors 12 hours a day in the studio. And it just kind of came about with a bass line that kind of got written over the top of, and was kind of one of our favorite songs that we wrote for this new EP. And it was really great to be able to put it out this fall and kind of base a lot of our tour around it. One thing that's been really nice to have is adding a Mellotron to my keyboard rig. Usually just had a Nord with kind of sampled sounds, but adding something more analog-y has kind of been fun to just expand the sound palette and just give a few more options for me to play and do different things. We've been using the G4 IAM system on all of our tours, but kind of the first time we plugged it in, none of us knew a whole lot about how to make it sound as good as possible. I mean, we could make it work, but not to the best of its capabilities with mixers and such. But this is kind of the first time with the G4s that we've really been able to get it sounding pretty close to a record and just really enjoy the experience on stage. Only sound check one song and it sounds great, not really touch a thing, and then just go up there and have fun and not have to worry about literally anything because it works so perfectly and never has an issue. Switching to the E945 vocal mics was a real game changer for our ears, because we've previously dealt with a ton of cymbal bleed on stage and tried, you know, mapping out our stage in different ways or baffles and such. But switching to the 945s reduced that cymbal bleed so significantly, because they're so hypercardioid, that it really completely solved the problem for us.
My name is Chris. I play drums for Winnetka Bowling League. So I have a 604 mounted with a Kelly shoe suspension system in the kick drum, as well as the 901. The toms, we actually use the 904s, which I like them. They're super robust, metal microphone. They sound awesome. Love the clips. Actually, you can see on my kit, we have no mic stands at all, which is, like, super cool. It just looks clean. It's consistent as far as what the mic placement is, and they just sound good. on snare top, we're actually using a vocal microphone. We're using one of the new 445 microphones on snare top, and on snare bottom, it's also a vocal microphone. We're using the 945. They just gave us the sound that we're looking for, that real like warm bass drum, but with the punch and the attack. The Sennheiser G4 IEM system has been a game changer for us on the road. I've always had an issue with getting the click loud enough in my ears, and I feel like the clarity of the packs and the entire transmitter system just lays the click in such a great place. It's weird, it almost feels like it comes from like inside my head. It's really hard to explain, but I feel like we've actually used some of the older Sennheiser stuff, and I feel like the new ones, like just the clarity really makes such a difference. We're really looking forward to 2022. Hopefully continue to be out there, tour for the new single, Pulp, and everything we got going on. So it's been awesome. Thank you so much for doing this. My sweet dandelion, where have you been lately? Because I miss you like our parents miss the 80s, riding city bikes. I thought you could save me from love.
Don't forget to like and subscribe to see more videos just like this.